willkommen zum Neujahrspresseempfang hier am Campo Morani-Platz. Wir freuen uns sehr, dass Sie so zahlreich erschienen sind. Hello and happy new year. Welcome to our new year's reception here in the camp at the Oranienplatz. The purpose of this event is to look back at the achievements and the perspective of the refugee movement. Sinn und Zweck dieser Veranstaltung ist, einen Jahresrückblick über das vergangene Jahr zu tätigen und nach vorne zu blicken in Bezug auf die Bewegung. About the languages, zum Thema Sprachen. We will have in several instances translation, I think English, German and Arabic at least.
Yeah, and maybe someone need the French, je ne sais pas si quelqu'un va arriver, qui a besoin. Est-ce qu'il y a quelqu'un qui a besoin du français? Oui, donc très bien. On va traduire en français, en anglais, en arabe et...
Une türkische Übersetzung, türkisch-deutsch.
Yes, en türkisch.
Okay, so for this...
There is someone who need a Persian? Who need a Persian?
Farsi Übersetzung?
Farsi. Persian. Farsi.
Okay. So for this reason I would like to ask everybody, refugees as well as journalists, to choose the words wisely and economically, because everything will be translated at least two times. Who's doing the Arabic translation?
He's doing the Arabic translation.
Okay.
Yes.
The welcome words.
قال علينا نشكر الجميع الصحافة اللي هم جاونا اليوم ونطلب منهم على أن الأسئلة تكون واضحة لكي الجواب يكون واضح. Alors, nous remercions les journalistes qui sont venus ici et nous demandons que les questions soient claires, précises, afin que nous puissions répondre dans le mérite et dans le fond de la question.
Here on the panel are Yassir, Napoli, Mahdi, Yahya, Habet, Patrick, Turgay, Ebru is doing the translation for Turgay. Habet is supporter, just as I'm supporter. She's doing the moderation. All the others are refugees. My name is David.
Hello. You need that? Do not need that we translate the name?
I don't think so.
Okay.
To give you a short outline for this meeting, we start by reading out the...
Yesterday we...
Excuse me. We start yes, out by
Grande
reading...
Cloud. Yes, sir.
By reading out the New Year's message from the protest camp of the Oranienplatz to all messages, all refugees and supporters in Germany, Europe and worldwide. After this, there will be the possibility for everybody to comment on this and for the journalists to ask questions. This, I believe, should take about 45 minutes. This is at least my idea. After this, there will be space and time for interviews. And on a more personal atmosphere, you can pair up, or you, the journalist, can go for grab yourself a refugee and ask all the questions that were not answered on this during the press conference. And also there will be the possibility to visit the camp and take pictures there for a guided tour of the camp. Soll ich das nochmal auf Deutsch sagen? Nein? Alle gründlich mit Englisch? Großartig. Okay.
Okay, warm welcome to everyone. We are going to start now by reading out the New Year's message for all the refugees in Germany and Europe and all over the world.
نحن سنبدأ الآن نرحب بجميع نقرأ إعلان نرحب بجميع اللاجئين في ألمانيا في أوروبا وفي العالم كله. Donc nous allons lire un message de solidarité avec tous les réfugiés d'ici de là-bas et d'ailleurs et du monde entier.
So Patrick, as part of the media group, will read out the New Year's message now for you.
First of all, I have to welcome everyone who is present, most especially our visitors, the journalists, plus my fellow refugees and our supporters.
فأنا أريد أن أرحب بالصحفيين الذين جاءونا يزورنا ونرحب باللاجئين وبالمناضلين الذين أتونا. Je commence par remercier les journalistes ici présents, remercier ensuite les chers réfugiés et demandeurs d'asile, et ensuite évidemment remercier nos supporters.
On behalf of the refugees and the media group, I will say Happy New Year to you.
Et je voudrais vous souhaiter la bonne année. وأريد أن أقول لكم كل سنة وأنتم طيبين.
Now here is our New Year's message to the general public.
هذا هو المساج يعني هذا هو الإعلان والذي سنعطيه لجميع العالم. Ça c'est évidemment le message que nous allons envoyer aux gens d'ici et d'ailleurs pour la nouvelle année.
We the refugees at Oranien Press, Berlin, protest, refugee protest camp. We send out our message, solidarity to all our fellow refugees and supporters in Germany, Europe and worldwide.
Nous envoyons un message de solidarité avec tous les réfugiés, tous les activistes des droits de l'homme du monde entier. نرسل مسج بتاع التضامن مع جميع اللاجئين وجميع المناضلين في العالم من هنا وهناك.
We shall stick on our theme. Enough is enough. It is time for resistance. We look back, we put our foot on this land after long journeys, suffering a lot of our diverse roots.
نحن بطبيعة الحال أتينا في هذا البلد بعد كثير من الآلام والألام. Les asbab khassa, enfin je traduis sommairement, nous avons passé des moments très difficiles pour nous retrouver à fouler le sol allemand, et ce évidemment avec beaucoup de difficultés.
Even though arriving here we find ourselves submitted under the reality of ghettos.
Nous nous sommes retrouvés soumis à une espèce de ghettisation du système allemand qui nous isole complètement par rapport à notre existence, je veux dire existentiellement. فنحن وجدنا نفوسنا منعزلين وجوديا والسيستم الألماني يضغط علينا ويفرض علينا على أننا نكون منعزلين.
In this we mean we are forced to live in lagers, treated like prisoners, submitted to decisions take over our head.
فهما بطبيعة الحال يحطونا في معسكرات. معسكرات فيها يعني ليس شكل فيها عنف. عنف الدولة وعنف السيستم. Nous sommes évidemment parqués dans des ghettos, dans des lagers, qui sont l'expression la plus violente de ce système.
And just receiving orders in the racistic manner.
Et nous avons seulement et nous ne faisons que recevoir des ordres et d'une façon raciste.
Racistic money.
Yeah.
Et de l'argent raciste, évidemment. ونحن ليس هناك عندنا حل آخر إلا أننا نأخذ الأوامر ويعطونا أموال ومادة فهي من نفسها مادة عنصرية.
Whereby we face some brutal restrictions like Lagerfeld. There's an entire lack of privacy in these lagers, and medical aid is provided for simply surviving. Any healing is not part of the plan.
Les conditions de vie existentielles, comme nous disions auparavant au début du texte, sont déplorables, pour ne pas dire miséreux et misérables, sans aucun respect pour les droits fondamentaux des êtres humains. C'est-à-dire que nous sommes vraiment parqués comme des animaux, les soins sont donnés au minimum, il n'y a absolument aucun respect pour l'élan essentiel de l'être humain.
In this manner, we feel like being handled as if we are objects.
في هذه اللاجرات ليس هناك احترام للحاجات الأساسية التي يجب على أن توفر للإنسان حتى من ناحية الطبية. فهم يفرضون علينا جميع من الأوامر ومن الحالة الاجتماعية التي هي ضد القوانين الأساسية التي موقع عليها في العالم كله.
Totally ignored as human beings.
وينساونا كإنسان. Donc ils nous ignorent en tant que, je dirais, élément constitutif humain de ce globe.
Now, our self-determination is taken away. We are forbidden to pick up proper work, yet are forced into low wage groups jobs. We and our children, we cannot go to school, and we are forced only to hang around in lagers, just eating and sleeping as our main job in the lagers.
Donc la structure, je dirais, sociale et sociologique de ces lagers est faite de telle façon qu'elle nous empêche d'avoir une vie décente, empêche nos enfants d'aller à l'école, nous empêche d'être des êtres humains tout simples. فهذه الحياة في اللاجر يعني تمنعنا من الحاجات اللي هي أساسية وتمنع أولادنا من المدرسة والثقافة والتعلم.
As our daily experience in Germany, or as far as
هذه هي تجربتنا في الحياة. Ce sont évidemment nos expériences vérifiées en Allemagne.
We are intentionally isolated from the surrounding society or community, so whereby the people ever often react to us with rejection and even exclusion.
Nous sommes isolés par la société. Par la société ici, on entend évidemment le système. On n'entend pas le citoyen. On est isolé par le système, qui est un système avec des lois qui sont clairement isolationnistes.
Such as in schools, we are isolated. In clubs, some discos, we cannot go there. Some public services, we are not welcome, so that's what we mean.
فهذا الوضع الاجتماعي الانعزال اللي خلينا منعزلين تماما يخلينا ليست لنا وجود في هذه الدولة ولا حياة اجتماعية ولا علاقات, لأن مفروض علينا قوانين تفرض علينا على أننا نبقى في مكان, على أننا نأكل في مكان, على أننا نعيش في مكان, وعلى أننا ما نتحرك من هذا المكان.
In this way, we live in a constant fear of verbal and physical attacks almost every day, everywhere in Germany, somebody of us get attacked, hurt, like hurt.
فنحن مفروض علينا يعني على أننا نعيش في الضغط النفسي والضغط الاجتماعي اللي عنده يعني سلبيات على عائلاتنا أولادنا زواجنا في الح... في في حياتهم الاجتماعية كلها. Donc il y a, enfin je résume un petit peu, il y a des conséquences vraiment, je dirais, psychosociales sur tous les demandeurs d'asile, parce qu'ils vivent dans un environnement très difficile, qui, comme on disait au début du texte, les isole.
Can you summarize?
We experience, on top of Lagerfrikt, we experience the problem of resident frikt, which is likely an open prison. We deprive our rights. It makes us subject of arbitrary and humiliating police controls all over Germany. For us, mobility equals us criminals.
La loi sur la résidence frist est celle qui limite l'environnement vital de tout demandeur d'asile, de tout enfant, de toute femme, de tout homme qui décide de quitter son pays parce qu'il est persécuté. Donc il est limité par une loi qui est fondamentalement inhumaine parce qu'on le limite géographiquement. Et cette loi s'appelle la loi sur la résidence pflicht. هذا القانون اللي قانون الريزيدنس فليشت هو اللي يخلي راجل مرته أولاده في محل جيوغرافي ما يقدروا يتحركوا منه وهذا فرض عليهم سيستم عنصري.
So last year what we did, we said enough is enough, it's now time for the real action for resistance. We stood up, both men and women, plus our children. We went over the street, putting up our tent action to to really let the public know that we are here, not just for funnies, but with very hurting issues. That's why we went on the street.
L'année dernière, les réfugiés ont décidé de prendre en main leur destin, d'appeler l'attention, d'attirer l'attention de la société sur les conditions de vie misérables et non respectueuses des droits de l'homme. Et donc, ils ont décidé de marcher, ils ont décidé d'occuper des espaces pour attirer l'attention des gens, des êtres, des, surtout du système et des citoyens, sur l'injustice qu'ils sont en train de vivre. C'est l'injustice et le racisme d'un système qu'il a érigé en loi. فاللاجئين أخذوا مصيرهم بيديهم وقالوا وقاموا وعملوا رجال ونساء وعملوا مصير واحتلوا أماكن لكي يلفتوا نظر السيستم ويلفتوا نظر المواطنين على هذه القوانين التي هي قوانين عنصرية وأكبر عنصرية موجودة في الدولة الأولى الدولة الأوروبية اللي اقتصاديا مزدهرة.
In the same way, we also let the government know that we are ready to resist all such kind of restrictions by breaking the isolation. First of all, by breaking the Lagerfrikt and the Residentfrikt when we led the march from Wolfsburg up to here.
C'est un petit peu ce qu'on a dit auparavant. Les réfugiés et les demandeurs d'asile ont décidé de prendre leur destin à main et en marchant, en cassant ce qu'on appelle la résidence Pflicht et la Lagerfrist, où on les oblige dans, ce, dans cette espèce de dictature géographique avec un environnement bien limité. Et donc ils ont décidé de marcher et de marcher 600 km pour arriver à Oranienplatz, occuper un espace public pour attirer l'attention des citoyens et des systèmes sur l'injustice que nous sommes en train de vivre. كما قال في الأول رجال ونساء أخذوا القرار على أنهم سيكافحون ضد الريزيدنس فليشت وضد اللاجر فليشت وضد الديبورتيشن وضد جميع أنواع من الـ من الـ من الـ العنف الدولي والسيستم الراسيست فأخذوا قرارهم بتحت يديهم وصار وعملوا مسيرة 600 كيلومتر حتى وصلوا إلى 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 أورانيوم بلاس وحتى عملوا حاجات أخرى وحركات أخرى.
So to show our seriousness in this part of in this struggle. We didn't mind. We walked the 600 kilometers up to here. We organized a big demo on the 13th at Brandenburg Tor. We followed that. We occupied the Nigerian embassy. Again, we went on hunger strike. We organized this, so many things to show the government that we are ready to face any kind of torture or brutal action. But we are here, and right now we say we are here at Oranian Platz, and we shall continue our fight here. As you have seen, last month we occupied again the school to show them that this is part of our demand to have the residents, and we can't leave our people starving on the winter in the cold, so that's why we occupied the school. But our main focus is here at Oranian Platz, and the struggle will continue here in whatever case.
Nous avons évidemment, comme vous le savez, occupé Oranian Platz. Nous avons appris Oranian Platz. Certains de nos frères et sœurs ont fait la grève de la faim à Paris à place. Nous avons occupé l'ambassade du Nigeria et nous venons d'occuper le 10 du mois dernier, le jour des droits de l'homme, le 10, le Conseil des Nations Unies pour les réfugiés. Nous l'avons occupé pendant une heure de temps, ce qui n'était jamais arrivé en Allemagne évidemment et ce qui n'est presque jamais arrivé dans un pays européen. Donc, comme vous voyez, nos activités vont continuer. Oranian Platz, c'est la mère de nos places. Nous n'allons jamais la laisser tant que ce pays n'a pas changé les droits fondamentaux des êtres humains. Nahna ihtallayna Oranian Platz. Dhahabna ila Paris à place. Wa amalu al-awlad al-idrab ala al-akl wa shurb. Wa dhahabna ila al-parlement. Wa dhahabna ila maktab al-umam al-muttahida yawm 10 fi hadha al-shahr wa ihtallayna muddat sa'a. Wa awwal marra tasir fi Europa. حاجة ما هذه ولن نقف أبدا حتى يتغير البرنامج لهذه الدولة العنصرية هذا السيستم العنصري. On ne va jamais s'arrêter tant que le système n'aura pas parlé avec nous directement les yeux dans les yeux et comprend que nos trois demandes sont fondamentales et que nous allons continuer jusqu'au bout à rester ici, à occuper des places, à continuer à faire de la politique, mais nous allons prendre notre destin à main. Nous sommes des êtres humains et nous demandons à ce que les droits fondamentaux des êtres humains soient respectés.
So I will not follow all the details on the paper because we have other things to talk and all these people they want to say something, but you will get more information as you read. But I will emphasize again on the following. We declare ourselves with the refugees that we will continue with our struggle, with our fight against all these black laws, racist laws, brutal laws that violate our rights and freedom and dignity.
فنحن نقرر على أننا كلاجئين سنكافح وسنزيد في الكفاح حتى هذه الدولة تحترم حقوقنا الأساسية. Nous déclarons officiellement que nous n'allons jamais nous arrêter de nous battre jusqu'à ce que ce système avec ses lois racistes prenne en considération nos droits fondamentaux en tant qu'êtres humains. Nous ne nous arrêterons jamais de lutter. Nous allons continuer à occuper des lieux, des marchés et tout ce qui est devant nous jusqu'à ce que ce système nous prenne en considération et abolisse ces lois racistes.
Therefore, in solidarity, we call all our fellow refugees everywhere, not only in Germany, but everywhere in the world, to come out and take the streets and demand their liberty and dignity. Again, we declare that strongly we condemn the evacuation of the protest camp in Vienna, which took place last month during December 20th, We want to let them know that we are together with them in this struggle, and we shall again build up our protest all over the world.
Nous demandons à tous les activistes, à tous les réfugiés d'abord, qui sont dans une situation... Nous demandons à tous les réfugiés d'abord, qui sont dans le monde entier, nous déclarons notre solidarité. Et nous demandons à tous les activistes pour les droits de l'homme de se joindre à nous pour exprimer notre désaccord contre tous les systèmes racistes qui se trouvent dans le monde, qui acculent les êtres humains à être considérés comme des animaux, et où le respect des droits fondamentaux des êtres humains n'est pas pris en considération. Nahnu kalaji'in nursil nidalna wa tadamunna ma'a jami' al-laji'in fi al-'alam wa natlub min jami' al-munadilin fi al-'alam ala annahum ya'tu ma'ana wa yakunu ma'ana fi al-shawara' fi al-aswaq fi al-duyur fi al-buyut fi al-makatib حتى على أننا نكافح ضد هذا السيستم الراسيست على أننا ضده.
We do not want to live in Lagos where we are isolated. We want to live freely and self-determined. We refuse to pay the bills of the wars and crises of the system. In that way, we strongly demand that resident freight must be abolished. Lagos freight must be abolished, and all kind of deportation must stop. And this we make it clear to the Federal Republic of Germany to respond positively to our demands before we take further actions. Thanks.
Les trois demandes fondamentales qui sont sur lesquelles se base notre mouvement et notre lutte sont l'arrêt et le stop de la Residenzpflicht, l'arrêt et le stop des Lagerpflicht, l'arrêt et le stop des déportations. Et c'est seulement quand ces trois demandes seront prises en considération que peut-être nous déciderons d'alentir un petit peu notre effort. Mais tant que le système ne l'aura pas fait, nous continuerons, comme nous l'avons dit, à lutter, à vous appeler, à vous prendre comme témoin et à vous dire que nous sommes là pour dire non à tout ce système raciste. نحن نأخذكم أنتم الصحفيين كشهود على أننا دائما سننادي لكم لكي تشهدوا على أنهم على أننا في دول عنصرية تفرض على الإنسان على أنه يكون مضغوط عليه كالكلب وحتى الكلب عنده بطاقة حتى الكلب. Ça, c'est un, ce sont des pays où les droits fondamentaux des êtres humains ne sont pas respectés. Nous allons, en tant que journalistes témoins des libertés fondamentales que vous êtes, parce que vous avez une profession noble et méritée, nous allons toujours vous prendre comme témoins sur la lutte que nous avons pour déterminer nos droits fondamentaux dans les pays qui sont signataires de la Convention de Genève, dans les pays qui sont signataires de la Déclaration universelle des droits de l'homme, dans les pays qui sont signataires de toutes les conventions européennes depuis 1944 jusqu'à aujourd'hui. L'Allemagne est l'un des premiers pays qui les a signés et nous allons toujours vous prendre comme témoin que les droits fondamentaux des êtres humains ne sont pas respectés, que la déportation doit être arrêtée, que la Residenzpflicht doit être arrêtée, que les Lagerpflicht doit être arrêtée. Et je vous remercie.
To ask questions. They will be translated first and then someone will answer.
My name is Philippe from the Federation Asset. It's in German?
In English.
Yeah. I have several questions. First of all, I would like to know how many refugee protest camps are currently in Germany and maybe you know in other countries. Second question is how many refugees live currently here at Oranienplatz in the camp and in school? And last question, how many face trial because of violating the Residenzpflicht?
Okay, there are three questions. Who would like to answer the first question? How many protest camps there are in Germany?
أول سؤال باقي أطرحه عليكم هو كم ألمانيا فيها من الكامبوات بتاع النضال للاجئين. ثانيا سؤالي الاخرين، كم من لاجئ يسكن هنا في اورانيوم كلاس، وكم لاجئ عندكم الساكن هنا؟ وسؤالي الثالث، كم عندكم من انسان يعني خارج له القانون الريزيدنت فليش؟ La première question que je vous pose, c'est combien de camps de protestes de réfugiés il y a en Allemagne. Deuxièmement, combien de personnes sont affectées de la résidence Pflicht. Et troisième question, combien de réfugiés sont à Oranienplatz ou ailleurs. C'est ça?
Et à l'école.
Et à l'école.
In
English? In English? He already said it in English.
Okay, Patrick will answer your question.
Patrick, say Joe.
Yeah, of course, there are very many protest camps in Germany, but in October, all of us from the protest camps, mainly we around 7 protest camps around, most especially from Bavaria. Like me, I was in the protest camp in Passau, but we had a protest camp in Nuremberg, Regensburg, Würzburg, Düsseldorf, and also Munich. It was not so big, Baden-Württemberg, and also here in Berlin. So in October, what we did on the 6th, all of us, we came here. We combined our effort to continue with our protest here. Internationally, we are also coordinating with other refugees from other countries, most especially in Austria, Vienna. We are the refugees right now, they are protesting and they are on the street. In Poland also, refugees, Poland.
Where
in Poland?
You mean the country Poland?
Yeah.
What's the name?
Jawostok.
Jawostok.
Yes, this is not a point.
Yes. Also in Denmark, Amsterdam, also the protests are going on. In Greece, not yet known where exactly they will set up their protest camp, but they're in process. In Italy too, they're in process. France too, they're in process to start. So the movement is not only in Germany, it is worldwide, because all these problems we are facing, they are not only facing us here, but as Europe. I didn't tell you this, but as Europe, since they raised their flag in 1958, they started to work like a chain. So every country is copying. You see last time what Austrian government did, Polizei. They copied from Germany what they did, or what they are doing to us. So that's what they did also, like the last event on 20th. The same thing they did to us at Brandenburg Tour, without any discussion or any negotiation. They didn't listen. They decided to take away our tent. Also the same thing, the Austrian police, that's what they did. They didn't listen to our fellow refugees. Maliciously, aggressively, they just, even they reached to the extent of bringing in graders. What is that? Where's democracy? So that's why we are here.
How many refugees do live in this camp?
At the moment,
we are 100 between here and school.
We are about 100 27, both here
and school.
And, school.
107.
And 27.
127.
Yes.
Both here and the school.
Yes.
Yeah, we have children. We have four families living in the school. Two families, they are from Romania. One family from
Palestine.
One family from Iran.
Two from Sudan.
And two families
from Sudan.
Yes, and two families, they are from Sudan. So all, there are six.
70 children.
And 17.
Yeah.
17. 17 children. And about seven of them, they are very kinder. Yes. Some, they are in school. So that's all about our movement.
And how about the trials? Are there already people facing trials because of violating the residents who live here in the camp or at school?
Yes, you are talking. Yes, we have now a seven case. Me personally, I remember you when I was coming out from the parliament, and since that date, now I received the residence fleshed papers, and my papers is going to the court, and I already told them that I am not going to come back to my lager to stay there more than 2 hours. Maybe just to see if I have a post or not. And yes, we have seven cases. Yes, seven cases right now. And they are good.
There will be more.
No, they are more already. But we are trying to have to with the legal support to do something against this type of illegality.
But who wants to know more about this?
Can I translate?
Ask legal support group.
Can I translate, please? فهو سأل كم الناس عندهم الآن resident finished. فأنا قلت له على أن كنا ستة وزدتنا عليهم ولينا سبعة على أني جاتني الورقة اللي تقول لي على أني أوراقي ترفع للمحكمة وعلى أني قلت لهم على أني ماني باقي في الدار أكثر من ساعة وأني سنرجع.
One point to make it clear on this side. Of such nonsense, what cases. Some of us, we have totally denied to pay any response to such cases. For instance, me and him and the other groups, we have refused to listen. We are not paying any energy for that, like receiving the posts and what. We say, let them do whatever they want. We are here in Germany. Freedom of movement is our right. So let them do whatever they want, but we are not ready to deal with them because whatever they are doing is nonsense. They say we apply lawyers or we get lawyers. These lawyers, they are all corrupted by racism. So everything is nothing they do. So we declare that we don't want anything. Most of us, some because you know, they fear, but most of us we say no, we don't want such nonsense.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions?
Yes. At the end of December, there was incidents in the school. Then the press conference here and couldn't take place because. You said that everybody can enter the school and you want more control of who's coming into the school. Has the situation in the school changed somehow?
قلت له هي المدرسة صارت فيها في آخر ديسمبر صارت فيها مشكلة وقلت لكم ما انكم تخلوا الناس يدخلوا ويخرجوا وهل الواحد يبقى يجوا. Alors elle pose la question, elle dit qu'au mois de décembre il y a eu quelques difficultés quelques échafourés dans l'école et quelles sont les choses qui ont éventuellement changé.
Okay, Napoli will answer your question.
Okay, thank you for your question. We had a conflict in the school, and that's, yeah, it took place, and we don't deny that, because our movement is, you know, fighting against the system, not against the human being. Even politicians, we are not against politicians, we are against the system. And here also when it started, we, you know, we tried to, you know, let's say, first of all, from the first point that, you know, we are the people who are contaminated already from our, where we came, like in Lagos, there is many killing, death, you know, somebody can just kill himself, somebody getting crazy, and, you know, some people are getting, you know, into fight and having knives in the labs. So that people are here now. So we try to heal ourselves where we are now. And we try to, you know, let's say control, at least, you know, we manage to control. That's not the first, you know, conflict. It was, there was conflict, and we are trying to, you know, come out with a group that can deal with the problem. And I can tell you also that problem is not a group problem or, you know, movement problem. It was, you know, a personal kind of problem. And now the police is taking a statement, and now it's under the control of police, and we will see what the police come out with that. I can just say in this short.
Alors, elle dit que, et évidemment, il y a eu des problèmes et des violences à l'école. Nous avons essayé de les résoudre à notre façon, évidemment. Mais c'est une réalité qui est tout à fait normale. Moi, je vais traduire à ma façon, qui est tout à fait normale. Parce que dans n'importe quel groupe qui se retrouve dans une structure désorganisée, évidemment, ressortent des espèces de violences qui sont incontrôlées, incontrôlables. Mais c'est tout à fait normal que ceci arrive. Ce que je veux ajouter pour ce qui est de ma part, et que je veux que vous les journalistes vous le sachiez très très bien, c'est que nous avons occupé l'école pas dans la mentalité du squat. Nous ne sommes pas des squatteurs. Dans la philosophie politique du squat, le réfugié n'est pas un squatteur. Il sort de son lager. Donc dans la continuité de la philosophie politique et même sociologique, je suis désolé, je suis sociologue de métier, ça ne rentre pas dans notre cadre ni philosophique ni politique. Nous ne sommes pas des squatteurs. Nous avons occupé cette maison pour donner aux réfugiés un lieu pour dormir, c'est tout. Et donc c'est pour ça que ce n'était pas, c'était très difficile au début, parce que les gens ont pensé qu'on allait y construire des châteaux, des discothèques et ceci. Non, on a occupé cette place pour faire dormir les demandeurs d'asile qui quittent les lagers. We occupy this place just to give a one safety place to sleep. We are not in our main demand as squatters, and we want you to write it that as a refugee we are not squatter.
We occupy.
We just we occupied it, but we are not squatter.
As we occupy the Olanian dot.
This is, you have really to know it. And we are not going to be manipulated by any kind of left side or little side from Berlin to push us to be a squatter. Because we are not. Nous ne sommes pas des squatters. Nobody from left, from right, from middle can push us like this to be a squatter, because we are not. We are refugees.
Okay, thank you for the answer. And to your question, I want to answer the question in the sense that because this is like this, that we are not house possessor, and we decided to have a group which is concerned about the school. So the school is closed now, the door of the school is closed, so only the people can enter who sleep there, and the asylum seekers come to Oranienplatz first, and they are supported by people here to go there, and sleeping places are prepared. The problem we had before was because of this squatting, a lot of people were interested and they just come in and made a lot of chaos also.
Who's controlling the entrance there?
This is us.
Yeah. One thing about the violence, as she said, we are human beings. This we can't avoid. But we are not, our energy is not fighting one another or fighting you. Only we fight you when you report something which is not good. Because mostly that is the most interest you have. Where there is a problem, you run quick. By that instant, I received a lot of phone calls asking what about the incident. I said, no, I will not say about it because I have no mandate from my federal refugees to talk about the incident. But you were interested, pressing me, please, please. They told us you are from the media group. Second, to that, but we like you. If you come, report something exactly. Come also, like now, come on our demos, report that. Why, if we have demos, you don't come and report something positive, but when we have problems, you are quick, no one to call you. Okay, I will not go there, but you are welcome that you are here. Another point, we didn't leave this case only to the police. We have internally in our movement, we have what we call Inter-Conflict Resolution Commission or group. This group, it's also still working on this case, investigating, asking and counseling people not to keep on this anger. So that's to let you know that we are ready to solve our problems internally and also externally where possible. But we have working groups. So that's
question.
There,
yeah,
to make it clear.
Another question?
Yes, first I want to express my deep respect for your actions because it's hard work for you and it's a great fight under these terrible conditions, you know, in the cold and in the rain. And another problem would be the financial side, you know. You have no money to live on. And how can Berlin people help you in this sense?
قالت لك أنا أول شيء احترمكم جدا على المجهود الذي تبذلوه في العيشة في هذا المكان وفي هذه الظروف الصعبة وأريد أن أطرح عليكم السؤال من الناحية المادية ماذا يقدرون يعملون أصحاب برلين لكي يساعدونكم على أنكم تكافحون Tout d'abord, je veux vous dire que j'ai beaucoup de respect pour le combat que vous menez dans des conditions atmosphériques difficiles. Dans des conditions atmosphériques difficiles. Et puis ensuite, je voudrais poser une question sur le volet financier. Comment peuvent faire les gens de Berlin pour vous aider à supporter tout cet effort? Yes, sir.
طيب انا برحب بالصحفيين وبقول لهم مرحبا بكم وبقول لهم نفس الكلام اللي قالوا بدري قصه بنتمنى انه يجونا دائما في كل الايجابيات اللي عندنا زي ما بيطرحوا السلبيات نحن هنتعلم من الطرح بتاعهم لكن برضه الناحيه الايجابيه ضروري يطرحوها علينا نحن هنا الحاجات اللي بنحتاجها يعني كثير من الحاجات اللي بنحتاجها لانه عندنا اسر بنحتاج ملابس شتويه بنحتاج لاكل قطع اطفال بنحتاج لتدفئه بنحتاج كثير من الاشياء اللي يجينا دعم هنا من الناس اللي حوالينا يعني كثير من الدعم لكن بنتمنى انه يتواصل الدعم و يعني الحاجات المطلوبه ممكن هنا في لسته الحاجات المطلوبه موجوده في الانفاقين ممكن اي انسان يطلع عليها دي الحاجات الاحتياجات بتاعتنا في الوقت الاسبوعي هنا
First, I would say thank you for everybody, for all the journalists are here now. And I would say that you are really welcome, and we hope that you're going to come often here. And about our needs or what they can do to help us, we have one list in InfoPoint. Our children, they need help. the family, they need help. Alors d'abord, je voulais vous remercier, tous les journalistes et vous demander de venir le plus souvent pour que nous puissions évidemment avoir des contacts et que, qu'il y ait une continuité dans ce rapport. Et deuxièmement, pour répondre spécifiquement à la question, il y a une liste à l'InfoPoint de tous nos besoins, des besoins des enfants et des besoins des familles et d'autres besoins. Et ceux de Berlin qui sont intéressés pour nous aider peuvent la consulter.
German supporters, and we have also supporters from different countries in Europe, like Italy, like French, even America. We have our friend here, supporters. He's over there, and also from England, we have supporters. Also, that's very great to us, and we have the neighbors who supporting us by bringing whatever food, and we have clothes. Everything, and then we said still we, our movement is going forward or continue whatever, I don't know, but this is from the politician to say yes, now you have freedom, you can go. I will not stand here, just I will go, run, not even I can put on some. So we have a bus tour that we really need help, because we need the gas, the oil, we need the bus for mobilizing our people, and that will be very great if the government, also I can say the government, because I'm against the system, I'm not against them. If somebody say, yeah, I can offer you the bus, why not? You are most welcome. And we have also supporters who are, having, a caravan, having the finance account that, people can also offer the money through a caravan account. And we have also here box. So then I said, of course, if there is any, please, even you are present here, it's great also help. And you are present now is very great for us.
D'abord, non mais je vais ajouter quelque chose. D'abord, je veux profiter de cette occasion vraiment que vous êtes là, les journalistes, pour remercier les fervents supporters que nous avons autour de nous. Nous avons la chance d'avoir des jeunes filles, des jeunes garçons, des vieux, des jeunes, qui sont autour de nous, qui nous ont permis à toute cette expérience que vous voyez pour qu'elle puisse exister. We don't arrive here without our supporters. And I take this occasion to say thank you to all our supporters. And they are doing amazing, amazing, and amazing job. And they are helping us to have the empowerment of asylum seekers right. And in my name personally, I mean, as an asylum seekers, I say thank you to all our supporters. Merci vraiment.
Thank you. I would like to add something as a supporter.
Also, this is a call for your solidarity. Most especially you, the journalists, we call you to support us. Please, don't wait us to call you, or don't wait a problem to erupt, but come and ask whatever is important or whatever you wish that maybe we need to let the public know. You come and we tell you, and you write an article or what on TV. Second to that, also we request you to help us to bring us together to the public. In that way, you can request your fellow people or German people to organize workshops. We can maybe in the open spaces like a cafe or in schools, you can call us, or you can organize something and call two or three or five of us. We come there, we have a simple discussion so that the German community, the German citizens, they get closer to us and they know us, you know, because it's one of the way how we're gonna achieve something or change something in our demands. It's not through the fight, because we have not that capacity, and we are freedom fighters, so we can't use any means, only solidarity and through our voice. So let us come together, where possible, organize something, call us. We have enough material. We have resident freaked film, we have the march film, we have our daily life here to show, to let the people know. And all our experiences in the lagers and our life here in Germany, so that we are connected to the community, which this community will let our brothers and sisters who are having this scheisse mind in them to know that we are human beings. So once they have the house in the parliament, they will have the idea, the right idea, what to discuss and what to say, so that we create a good, a conducive environment to all of us, not only we refugees, but and you German people, so that we have a nice world to live.
Shortly, I want to add to this as a supporter. I would like to ask for support, for daily support to help with the kitchen, with the food, with the cleaning, with the safety, as we have security shifts like every night, so the people can, and for the information, for the info tent, so that the people here, the refugees, can focus on the political work and don't have to do all these things around.
He said, action. In a few months, we're going to ask a citizen. In a few months, we're going to ask first, we're going to make one bus tour to bring asylum seekers to break a residence flesh and stay here with us. This is the first point. Second point, in a few weeks, so maybe 2 months, we are asking all the citizens here in Kreuzberg or around and our supporters to come here and build one small tent with his name and his photocopy of his passport. In all this Oranien Plus, this is now, it's a scope, I give it to you. We are planning it's our plan to do it. We're gonna have 2 days for 10 days here in Oranien Plus.
You invite the people from Kreuzberg?
From Kreuzberg, from everywhere.
No,
yes, to build the tent, to stay with us when the time, the weather is good, to protest with us, to show the support. أنا قلت لهم على أننا نحن في شهرين أو شهرين ونص تقريبا سنطلب من سكان كويسبرغ ومن سكان برلين على أنهم يجوا هنا يبنوا خيم صغيرة كل عائلة وكل واحد يبني خيمة حدا هذا في أورانيوم بلاس لكي يولوا وعلنا عندنا برنامج آخر هو الباستو نمشوا للاجرات ومن اللاجر نجيبوا نجيبوا لي ريفوجي اي لي ريزيرف. Alors j'ai dit que notre premier projet évidemment c'est le bastou. Le bastou consiste à amener des demandeurs d'asile et des réfugiés qui ont cassé la résidence Flicht et la Lagerflicht et qui donc sont en plein dans notre combat politique. Deuxièmement, nous allons faire une action qui est une action de protestation et de soutien de nos supporters de Kreuzberg et de Berlin qui voudront bien, dans quelques mois nous allons le décider, mais c'est un scoop. C'est de venir planter une tente et de venir planter une tente à Oranium Place. Et nous allons aussi continuer à occuper le maximum d'espace. Nous avons des actions qui vont se préparer contre la déportation. Nous n'avons pas de choses très précises, mais comme vous avez dans ce cas-là, il faut toujours un certain effet de surprise pour éviter les problèmes avec la police.
Your question is what we are planning in the coming days. We of course have many plans because we are in a better field. We have strategies. We have, you know, attack and all this one. We are soldier, but not soldier that you know, soldier of, you know, fighting somebody. We are soldier here, that's why we are here. And also, you know, always as a soldier cannot tell you what is the plan. You know, let it be, you know, like surprise, okay? And I'll just flash you that we have many things. Yeah, we have many things like demonstration. It will be, again, great demonstration. So be ready for joining us that time. Thank you.
And today at 3 o'clock, there will be a solidarity demonstration because of this incident in the discotheque. As you know, maybe in Schöneberg, someone got really seriously hurt by a racist, and there are people gonna go there from here. So if you are interested, you can come with us, you can join us.
Yes. Maybe also it's an announcement. It's already planned. On 7th, we shall also have a demo in commemoration of our brother, Ole Ojelo, who were killed in Dessau. It's now some time back. So on 7th, of this month, we shall have a big demo in the cell. Also, addition to our plan, future plan, concrete one. Even though my sister, she said we cannot open it so much, but I will open it because it will be very big one and very big, where we call you to support it when time comes. But it is being prepared. We are planning a very big demo, but we changed the date. It will be in March. And this on this day, we shall have our birthday of this movement because we began our movement in March last year. So on this day, we are planning a big demo from here up to the parliament. And we shall have about 3 petitions to present to the parliament. So in that way, that's what we want to organize and to inform you. In the shortcomings, we also having workshops, like on 10th, we shall have a workshop with our lawyers in terms of legal defense who are advising us and working on our legal position as far as our asylum is concerned. So we have a lawyer's workshop on 10th. Again on 15th, we have another workshop about our refugee politics here in Germany, how it is. We want to talk about it because we have new our brothers who have just joined and who have just arrived in Germany. So we want them to know that Germany is not a joke. So you must understand, or we must understand our politics here. And we must take serious measures how to achieve our goals. For the time being, that's what we are planning, and we shall let you know more further important issues.
Okay, any more questions? thank you for coming. You will have the opportunity to have interviews now. Here are also information about Dublin 2. Who want to write something about Dublin 2? and you can also ask people who are affected by it. Tugay was one of those who were on the march. So you can have interviews now, and for the visitation of the camp, there's Walid. Walid, could you soon? Yeah, you can follow Walid to go to the camp. Thank you for coming.
Excuse us.
Sorry.
Yeah, we have a plan for you to see part of the videos, our life shortly. It will not take so long. And Claudio, one of our supporters, and is one concerned with the Lego defense. So he will show you something. And if you want, you can have even the clip from that.